Okay, so in this video, let's go over some gestures within our application. And what we'll do is we'll implement these gestures on our recent view controller here. So this would be the recents, and this would be the third tab within our tab bar here. And what we'll do is we'll go into the recent view controller, and then let's change this from recents to gestures, just so we can reference that later when we come back to this. So we'll change this text over here for this label. So this label right here, we'll change to that. And what we'll do is let's extract this label. Let's take it out of the load view and put it in its own method here. And we'll go ahead and add label there. That way, when the load view is loaded, it still loads the same thing, but it's a little cleaner to read. And right below that, we'll add in gestures. So we're going to create a method for that. And what we'll do is add that right here. So gestures. And in this gestures, what we need to do is we need to implement some UI gesture recognizers. So we're going to add and we're going to use all of these just to kind of demonstrate what they do here. So I'll paste those in. And we're going to add some information to this. And each one of these, if you want to implement them onto your application, you need to init them with a target and an action. So, or you could also use the .new or .allocate.init, but just to speed things up, we're going to combine all of that into the init with target. So just like you would with the regular allocate.init, what you would do is instead of using init, you use init with target. And I'll go ahead and I'll just copy this. And what I'll do is add this to each one of these. Okay, and the targets, so I'll go ahead and I'll select all of these. The targets will take the target itself. So what are you going to target? You're going to target this controller, this view controller. And then what it needs is an action. So let's check to see how that's implemented. So we just do action with a colon. So action colon, and then we're going to pass through our action here. So each one of these actions is going to start with a colon on its own. And what I'll do is I'll implement these individually. So for this one, it's going to be a tap gesture. So I'll go ahead and place that in an instance variable. This one will be a pinch. And then so on and so forth. So what I'll do is I'll pause the video real quick so I can implement this, and then I'll explain it in just a second. Okay, so what I've done is I've assigned each one of these gestures to their own instance variable here. And what I want to do now is add action to each one of these. Now these actions haven't been created yet, but we'll go ahead and create them right after this. So for this first one, we'll do a tap underscore action, and then we'll do a pinch underscore action, and then I'll pause this video and I'll implement the same thing for all of these, and we now have them implemented. So each one of these has their own action to it. For the tap action, we have tap action, then pinch action, rotate, swipe, pan, screen, pan, forgot to add action to that one, and then the long press action. So now that we've associated the action with the actual gesture, what we need to do next is go ahead and implement those right below here. So for this one, we'll do a tap action. And then in this tap action, we're going to go ahead and put tap action if the state of that gesture has ended. So how do we tell if it's ended or not? Well, if we go back into our UI gesture recognizer class, and we take a look at getting the recognizer state and view, we can check the state here. So what we'll do is we'll take the state and we'll get the tap.state. If that equals the UI gesture recognizer state, if it equals a state that has ended, then it'll go ahead and it'll put tap action within our terminal here. So let's just demonstrate how that would look. So in order to get the gesture working with our view here, we actually have to add it to the view by doing a view. And if we go into, again, our UI gesture recognizer, and we tap on the gesture. So let's go ahead and go to the gesture. And let's see, actually scroll up, go to the top of this, and right here, add gesture recognizer. So we'll take this, and it needs to be added to the UI view. So we'll take view dot gesture, add gesture recognizer. Let me get that correct. Add gesture recognizer, and we're gonna add in that tap. Okay, so this should add it to the view. We have the gestures added, we have this. One last thing we need to do is add this as an adder accessor. So, adder accessor for tap. Okay, now we will rerun our simulator. And then we'll make our way to the recents controller. You notice that the label has changed, the title has changed. Now what we're expecting is if we touch or tap the screen, we're expecting the terminal to say tap action. So we'll do that once, and boom, we have our tap action here. So that's working great. Let me go back into our simulator and do this a couple times. So you'll see that our terminal, our console, is now showing tap action repeatedly. Now, what we want to do is go ahead and implement all of these gestures and add them to our view. So once again, I'll pause this video and I'll basically copy the same action, rename it for each one of these. So instead of tap action, it'll be pinch action, then rotate action, swipe action, pan action, and I'll just copy them all below here. And then I'll add in the add gesture recognizer for each one of these. Okay, so I've now added a action for each one of these gestures here. Everything from our tap action to our long press action. Then I've added each one of those gestures to our view. And the last thing I need to do is go ahead and add these to our adder accessor. So what I'll do is I'll just go ahead and paste this in. And then I'm going to copy each one of these and remove that. And then add a comma and a colon for each one. Okay, now I just need to select those parentheses and delete them. Okay, looks like I added tap twice here. Okay, great, so that should now work. And what I will do is rerun the simulator here, and we should see that we should be able to use some of these actions here, or some of these gestures here. Now, one thing I've noticed while I was studying up on this is that the swipe gesture and the screen pan gesture need two more properties in there. So what we'll do is go to the recents, and then we'll take a look at some of these actions here. So for tap, we've already tested that. If we tap on the screen, you'll see the action there. Pinch, if you use option on your keyboard, you'll see these two gray dots here. That basically allows you to simulate having two fingers on the screen. And if we click and bring these together, it will simulate a pinch action. So that's working great. Now we'll do the same thing for the rotate action. What we'll do is we'll hold on the option key, and then rotating would be rotating it like this. So if we click and rotate like that, what will happen is once we let go, it'll initiate that rotate action or that gesture. And for the pan and the long press, these two will work, while the swipe and screen pan, like I said, need another property in there. So for the long press, if instead of tapping and letting go real quickly, if we just press on the screen on our simulator and then let go, it'll simulate that long press action. Now this pan right here, if we just click, hold, and move our finger anywhere on the screen, it'll initiate a pan. I held it too long, so it's initiating a long press action. So I'll hold and I'll move the on my finger or the simulator, and it introduce a pan action. So I can do that a couple times real quick, and we're just panning. Okay, so next, the screen pan, if we take a look at the screen edge pan, this gesture is looking for a dragging event towards the edge of the screen. And in order to get this going, we actually need to define the edges for this gesture. So what we'll do is we'll define the edges property. It needs to be passing or set to a UI rec edge constant. So what we'll do is we'll use the right edge for this one. So I'll copy that and we'll go here and add in screen pan dot edge equals UI rec edge right. And so if we go back into our simulator, and once we rerun this, if we start from this far right hand side and we pan to the left, it'll, instead of initiating a pan action, it'll go ahead and initiate a screen pan action. But before we fire that up, let's go back into our swipe and let's get this going here. So swipe dot, and what property do we need to pass through here? We'll go to UI swipe gesture recognizer, and we need to give it the direction property. And so this will take a UI swipe gesture recognizer direction, and we'll set that to the right as well. So I'll go ahead and go here and put in direction equals UI swipe gesture recognizer direction right. Now, as long as the pan is set, what will happen is the pan will override the swipe for this example case. But for now, let's go ahead and just rerun that simulator and see exactly what I'm talking about here. If we go to our recents controller, oops, looks like we have a crash set here. Let's see what that's about. Let's see, the gesture edge, oh, should be edges, I believe. So edges, let's double check that. Go to UI screen edge, yeah, edges. Okay, so now if I rerun this, it should work rather than crashing again. Okay, so we'll go to our recents, and then let's go to the right-hand side, the far right-hand side, and let's try panning to the left. Okay, great. It is initiating our screen pan action, just like we wanted to. Now, we want to test out the UI swipe gesture recognizer. So what we'll do is we'll try swiping to the right, and we're getting a pan action, just like I mentioned. So the pan is overriding the swipe with this example. So what we'll do just to test this out is to remove that add gesture recognizer for the pan. Then we'll restart our simulator and we should get that screen, we should get that gesture for the swiping action. Okay, we'll go back to our recents and let's swipe to the right and we get that swipe action. Now if we swipe to the left and we start from the far right, we still get our screen action. So that's what I mean by the panning overriding the swipe action. Now there are some techniques to make sure that your swipe action or your swipe gesture works on your specific object that you're trying to use it on, but we won't get into that into this video. I just wanted to kind of show you guys the different gestures that you could use within your application. So now that we have all of those gestures working, I think we can wrap up this video. If you guys haven't already, please subscribe and I'll see you in the next video.